Hi, I'm Connor Shields. I took the AP test, so basically, I have a PhD in physics. Now, today we are going to be analyzing some physics movie moments. The first movie moment will be in one of my personal favorite films, Star Wars. So, without further ado.
Take evasive action. Green goo, skip across the whole sector of each other.
Enemy ships in Sector 47!
It's a trap!
Fighters coming in!
There's too many of them!
Accelerate to attack speed. Draw their fire away from the cruisers.
Copy, Gold Leader.
This battle might have you saying, "It's a trap." Yes, it is. This battle is awesome, but completely unrealistic. The whole battle, you can hear the sounds of racing spaceships and firing blasters. Unfortunately, physics does not work that way. Sound is vibrations that travel through the air or another medium, and yet they're in outer space. There's no medium. So the sound wave would not have any medium to travel through, so there wouldn't be any sound outside of the spaceships. Sorry, Star Wars. Brianna will be analyzing the next film, Fast and Furious 6. The Fast and Furious movies tend to disregard physics altogether, so this one will be a treat.
Hey guys, today we will be looking at the logistics behind the Fast and Furious movies. Now we all know that these movies are known for their crazy action sequences and often leave you wondering, is this even possible? Today we will look specifically at the Fast and Furious 6 movie and the scene where Dom jumps off the bridge to save Letty's life, and as many people like to call it, or I like to call it, the jump. As you can see in this movie clip we just showed you, once Dom catches Letty, they initially start traveling in the direction that Dom was heading in, but in reality, they would have fallen somewhere in between the two bridges, because we also have to take into consideration that Letty has a momentum in the opposite direction as Dom, and due to the conservation of momentum, Letty's momentum should have carried them somewhere parallel to the bridges, because we can roughly assume that they have about the same momentum when they hit, or the same speed, and once they do hit, their momentums almost cancel out, leaving them to fall in between the two bridges where she was caught. And even if we did, say, give them the benefit of the doubt, saying they could make it to the other side of the bridge, once they do, they crash into a car without seemingly a scratch on them. And if we were to estimate the acceleration, we can see how this is almost impossible. So we can guesstimate that their speed is roughly 35 meters per second, and they stop in the distance of the compressed windshield, which we can guess is about 0.1 meters or 10 centimeters. And if we were to write this in equation, it would represent final velocity squared equals initial velocity squared plus 2 times the acceleration times distance. And if we were to isolate the a, that would make it initial velocity squared over 2 times distance. And if we were to use that, plugging in our numbers, we would get 35 squared over 2 times 0.1. And their acceleration would equal 6,125. So they hit the car with an acceleration of over 6,000 meters per second squared. And when we calculate this, this can translate into 600 Gs, which is Gs represented by G-force. And a G-force is just a measure of kinetic energy, usually experienced through acceleration or deceleration, and in our case, we would use acceleration. And let's say in a normal car crash simulator for the average male, 75 Gs is considered fatal. So even if Dom were somehow, say, compensate for Letty's momentum, the crash alone would have killed them. Alright guys, thanks for joining me. Today we'll be moving to Katie, who will be analyzing the movie Speed.
Everybody hold on!
Thank you.
logistically, the famed jump that the bus makes in the 1994 movie Speed wouldn't work. In the movie, they jump across a gap of unfinished highway that is at least 50 feet at a mere 68 miles per hour. The piece of highway that they land on is the same height as the piece that they took off from. For the bus to make that flat jump, there would have had to have been absolutely no external factors such as gravity, air resistance, and uneven weight distribution, which is impossible. When taking gravity into account, the sheer weight of the bus would have forced it to drop a distance greater than at least 1 meter while in the air. In the movie, the front of the bus is also angled upwards during the landing. Gravity would have sent the bus into a nosedive, so the front of the bus couldn't have been higher than or even just as high as when it left the first piece of highway. Many scientists, including Mythbusters, have proved that this jump would not work. Some scientists claim that if the highway had an incline of 5 degrees, it could have theoretically made the jump. But there are two problems with that. First, there was no 5-degree incline in the movie. And second, there was a behind-the-scenes video where they put a ramp up that had greater than a 5-degree incline to see if the bus would make it, and that didn't work. The sheer force of the jump caused so much damage to the bus. The front was falling off, there was oil leaking, and it almost slowed to a complete stop. In the movie, the bus has to stay above 50 miles per hour or it will blow up. And there is no way that the bus in the behind the scenes video that had made the jump would have been able to continue at above 50 miles per hour.
Space, the final frontier.